Hi. Today we have to discuss the topic that is the subject verb agreement. I'm going to share the screen so that you can see. I will tell you each and everything there and the different rules, how to use a subject verb agreement and where to use and what are the different principles to use subject verb agreement and what does it mean the subject verb agreement. We have already discussed this topic. Again, we are discussing here. Actually, the term subject verb agreement represents that whenever the subject is there, whatever the condition of the subject is there, you have to use a verb according to the condition and according to the nature of that subject. You have to write down, you have to keep, and you have to put the verb by looking at the nature, by looking at the subject of that verb. You have to put and you have to write down the verb according to the nature of the subject. If the subject is the singular, you have to write down the singular verb. If the subject is a plural, you have to write down the plural verb at that time. Both subject and verb have a interconnected relationship with each other. Both are intermixed and mixed with each other in such a way that you cannot exclude any one of the things from both of these two things. Both are the important part of any sentence. You have to write down the sentences according to the nature of the subject. So I'm going to share the screen where we have to discuss this topic. The title of the topic is the subject verb agreement. What are the basic rules to use the subject verb agreement? I told you that what is the meaning of the subject verb agreement. Now we have to discuss and we have to see the different examples of the subject verb agreement here in this file. Whenever the singular subjects, now that is written here, that singular subjects must have the singular verbs, plural subjects have plural verbs. So you have to write down the verbs according to the nature of the subject. If the subject is a singular, you have to write down the singular verb. If the subject is a plural, you have to write down the plural verb at that time. Another thing is that the pronoun you always takes a plural verb. Pronoun is always used as a plural and it always takes a plural verb with itself. For example, you can see here the examples. You were invited to come. You was invited is the incorrect form. You cannot use was here whenever you are using the you at the place of the subject. You were invited to come here. You is mostly used at the, in the plural form. You are asked to clean the room. If you are, if the meaning of the you is in the singular form, at the place of that or at that position, at that condition, you have to use even the plural verb at that with the singular subject you. You sing so well. So you have to write down the plural forms of the verbs with the word or with the subject you. Another thing is that if a sentence begins with here or there, these are the two words, here or there, the verb agrees with the subject which follows it. If the in the subject, whatever is written in the subject, the verb will be according to the nature of the subjects. For example, see here. Here are the ways on how to preserve me. So here are the ways. Are is a plural form of the verb. There is a huge gap between the rich and the poor. You have to use the verbs according to the nature of the subject. If in the subject here represents the plural forms, then you have to use a plural verb there. If in the subjects there represent the singular form, then you have to use the singular verb at that place. If at the place of if there is used in the plural form as the subject is used as a plural form, then you have to use the verb in the plural form as well. There are many plates on the table. See the example. There are many plates on the table. There are many plates on the table represents that we are representing something that is in the plural form. That's why we are using the verb in the plural format as well. You have to see the nature of the sentence and context of the sentence as well. Then you have to use the verbs accordingly. There is also used in the singular form, and here is also used in the singular form. Here is also used at the place of the plural meaning, and there is also used at the place of the plural meaning as well. So you have to see the background and the context of the sentence, then you have to use the verbs. In the third point, if two subjects, one single and one plural, are connected by either, or, neither, not. If in the subjects, two subjects are there, one single and another one is plural, and we are giving the words either, or, neither, not, and these words are used to connect those subjects and the sentence, the verb agrees with the nearer subject. At that time, you have to use the word according to the rule that whenever any subject that is near to the, it is written, the verb agrees with the nearer subjects. Whenever any subject that is near to the neither or either, you have to see that subject and then you have to use the verb. For example, you can see the example and you can clarify your idea here. Neither the players nor the coach. See, coach is a subject here, and it is near, not the coach. Neither the players nor the coach is joining. So you can see what is written in this point, that if two subjects, one single and one plural, are connected by either, or, neither, not, the verb agrees with the nearest subjects. The nearest subject, that is the subject that is near to the either, or neither, or not, we have to use the verb according to that nature. See here, in this sentence, neither the players nor the coach. The verb is used according to the nature of the subject coach here. The subject that is near to the verb, we have to see the subject that is near to the verb, then we have to use the verb according to the nature of that subject. If the subject here is a plural, coaches, if we have the word coaches here, then we can use the word is from here, and we can use the are here at the place of this verb. Because coaches is the subject, and it is used, if it is used in the plural form, then we have to use a plural verb. We have to use the verbs according to the nature of the subject. Either that subject is near to that verb, and either that subject is in the singular form or in the plural form. Again, either the conductor or the singers. Now you can see either the conductor or the singers. Singers is the plural form, and this is the subject, and this is the plural form. That's why we are using the are attending the consonant. Or is a plural verb. So you have to see the subjects that is near to the verb, and then you have to use a verb according to the nature of that subject. If that subject that is near to the verb is a plural, then you have to use a plural verb. If the subject that is near to the verb is a singular, then you have to use a singular verb. Then at the fourth number, it is written, a singular subject followed by intervening words or phrases, such as if we have the singular subjects and it is followed by the words, for example, with, as well as, in addition to, accompanied by, together with, and no less than, takes a singular verb. If these words are used with a singular singular subjects, then you have to use a singular verb. For example, Jack, accompanied by his sister, is enrolling in PCC. So you can use how these words are used here, and you have to use a singular verb. Daddy, as well as, my brothers. You can see brothers is a plural, but we are using the singular verb here, is enjoying the party, because they are written with the help of the particular words. For example, as well as, and accompanies. That's why we have to use the verbs according to the nature of these words. In the fifth rule, singular subjects joined by int require a plural verb. There are singular subjects, and those subjects are joined by int. We have to use the plural verb, except when they mean one thing. See the example. Larry and Mercy are reading novels. You can see singular subjects. Larry and Mercy, both are the singular subjects, but both subjects are the related, are connected with the end word here. So whenever the two subjects are there and both subjects are interconnected with the word and, at that time you have to use the plural verb. But whenever there are two subjects but they have the one meaning, at that time you have to use the singular verb. My teacher and friend is here. Now in this example, there is someone whose teacher and friend of someone else. And if you are referring and giving reference to reference of that particular person, at that time you can use the verb in the singular format. That person is your teacher and that person is your friend as well. That's why you have the singular meaning for that. So we have to use the singular verb there. Two singular subjects joined by either or, neither nor, take a singular verb. If there are two singular subjects and both of the subjects are joined by the words either or and neither nor, at that time you have to use a singular verb. For example, either mummy or daddy is coming with me at the outbound. Either mummy or daddy. Now you can see both of the subjects, you can see two singular subjects joined. Two singular subjects are there. Mummy or daddy. Both are the subjects, two singular subjects, and they are joined by the word either or. Then we have to use a singular verb. Coming with me at the outbound. Neither Faldi nor Dulis is waiting for you. So you got the example. You can see this example and you can clarify your meaning as well. In the seventh rule, if a singular subject is followed by a phrase containing a plural noun, the verb is singular. If a singular subject is there, but that singular subject is followed by the plural noun, followed by a phrase containing a plural noun, the verb is singular. For example, one of the boys is yelling so loud. See, whenever you are referring, see here. If a singular subject is followed by a phrase containing a plural noun, you can see here, whenever in the subjects, there is a singular form, or we can say singular subject is there, but that singular subject is followed by a phrase of the noun, that noun is in the plural form, then you have to use the verb in the singular form. For example, one of the boys. One here represents the singular subject. Boys here represents the plural form of the nouns here. Whenever any subject that is singular but followed by the plural noun, at that time you have to use the singular verb. For example, one of my most favorite books. Now you can see in this example as well. I'm giving you the example not from this, but I'm giving you the example, another example, that it is one of the favorite books. So here it represents the plural form of the nouns, plural meanings, that from many of the books I like one book. So whenever you are giving the reference, whenever you are giving the reference from the plural forms, and then you are pointing there just one thing, at that time you have to use a singular subject. One of my favorite books is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen, for example, if I saw like this. So you can get the idea. For example, one of my favorite universities is Aga Khan Foundation. So in this example, or in this type of the example, you have to be very careful whenever you are pointing out at one thing from the many things, from the plural things. At that time, you have to use the verb in the singular form. One of the members is against the rule. Mostly we give the example, one of your classmates come to my office and started crying about the marks that he got. For example, if I say like that, if I give you the example, one of your classmates, it represents that we are referring to one particular student from the all of your class fellows. Come to my office. It represents came or come. Come to my office. If I say come to my office, here again we are using the first person. are the not first person but first form of the verb here. And in the first form, we are using the present simple, and we can say that we are using the singular verb there. That's why we have to be very careful whenever using whenever you are using the plural nouns, and we are just pointing out at one thing at the time of the plural nouns. At one rule, the indefinite pronouns several, few, both, many, others are always plural. These are the words that the always take plural forms of the verb. These are the indefinite pronouns several. These are the words like several, few, both, many, others. For example, both were asking to be free. Several are seeking justice. 9-1, the indefinite pronouns some, most, all, none. Now these are the words that always take singular or plural according to the meaning of the sentence. These words always are singular or plural verb according to the nature of the sentence and according to the meaning of the sentence. For example, so these words can take the either can go for the singular verbs or they can go for the plural verbs as well. Some of the girls were absent, some of the ice cream is love. So you can see here that the sum is used in both the contexts. In the number one context, the plural verb is used. There were some of the girls. And in the second example, second sentence, the singular form of the sentence is used. A singular verb is used here. 10-1 rule. When any of the following indefinite pronoun is a subject, the verb is singular. Now, if these words are used in the place of the subjects, and these words are indefinite pronouns, at that time the verb is always singular. Everybody, each, no one, another, anybody, nobody, every, nothing, everything, anyone, either, neither, everyone, somebody, someone. These are the words that always take the singular verbs with themselves. Every man and woman in this hall is a member. Number 11 rule. Expressions of time, money, weight, and distance are singular even if the form is plural. Even if the form is plural, these words always are singular. 2 years is a long time to wait. 2 years is a plural form, plural subjects, but we have used the singular verb here. 2 years is a long time to wait. $1 million is a plural subjects, $1 million, but we are using the verb here as a singular verb, was given back to the owner. 12th, when the amount of the money refers to separate unit, the verb is plural. When the amount of the money refers to the separate unit, at that time we have to use a plural verb. 525 Santos coins were found, 600 peso bills were added to the budget. So we have to use and we have to remember all these rules and regulations whenever we are using the different type of the sentences, and we are like we start writing practical writing or academic writing. Number 13, the following words are always plural. Pens, these are mostly these can be singular in the meaning, but they are always used in the form of the plurals. They may be used in the singular meaning, but are always written in the plural form. Pants, trousers, pliers, scissors, shears, tongs. However, if the word pair is used, the verb is singular. If you are using the pair word, pair of the pants, at that time you have to use the verb singular. But if you are using these words particularly, at that time you have to use the plural verbs there. The pens are torn into two. Now the pens are torn into two. The one pen here, the meaning is singular. That one pen is torn, is broken or is torn into two parts. But we are writing here in the plural context because the nature of the words. The pair, now see the pair, if we are using the word pair, the pair of scissors was placed on the table. Then we have to use a singular verb. If we are not using the word pair, then we have to use the plural verbs. For example, scissors were placed on the table. If we remove the first part, that is the pair of. We remove this first part and we just start the sentence with the scissors. Then we have to change the verb here as well. We can write down the verb in the plural form. Scissors were placed. At the place of the was, we have to use the verb were. Yeah, scissors were placed on the table. If you are using the word pair, then you have to use a singular verb. If you are not using the word pair, then you have to use the plural verbs there. 14 rules. Certain nouns, though plural in form, are singular in meaning. There are many nouns who are in the plural form, but they have the singular meaning. For example, your mathematics subjects, your politics politics. These are the subjects that that are mostly seem as a plural, but they have the singular in they are the singular in meaning. Mathematics is my favorite subjects. Mathematics is one of the subjects. It may be give the idea that we are referring to the plural things, but it gives the singular meaning here. The latest news, the word news is also a singular meaning. Can be you can the is seem the word news seems as a plural, but it gives a singular meaning here. The latest news is alarming to the public. 15th rule, that is, when the word is preceded by a, it takes a plural verb. When it is preceded by the, these are the articles. When any verb, when the word is preceded by a, it takes a plural verb. When any sentence in any verb, whenever it starts, takes the definite and indefinite articles, these are the a while at that time we have to use a plural verb. When it is preceded by the, it acts a singular verb. For example, a number, a here represents a number of students are waiting outside. Whenever any word that takes a, at that time we are using the plural verb. Whenever any word that takes the, at that time we have to use a singular verb. The number of the students outside is not recorded yet. 16th rule, that is, when fractions are used, the verb agrees with the object of the phrase. Whenever you are going for the mathematics and whenever you are using the fractions at that time, you have to use the verb agrees with the object of the phrase, according to the object of the phrase. One half of the cake was consumed. One fourth of the employees were attending the seminar. Then we have the 17th rule, that is, these nouns may be singular or plural in meanings. These nouns may be as singular and are plural in the meanings. Athletics, genetics, politics, gymnastics, statistics. When the noun refers to an organized activity, it is a singular. When you are using these words in the form of the one organization or in the form of the one department, at that time you have to use a singular. They are used in the singular format. Form when the noun refers to the activities of the individual, but when you are pointing out the activities of an individual, particular activities of the individual within a group, or to varied activity, it is plural. These can be used in the singular or plural meanings. In both of the words, these words are used in the singular and plural meanings, but it depends on the context or the background of the sentence. That if you are referring these words in the in the form of the organization or in the organized form or in the one of the activities or in the form of the activity, at that time you have to use these words in the singular form. But if these words if you are using these words in the context of the activities of the particular individual and the singular individual within a one group are pointing out singular individual, at that time you have to use these words in the form of the plural. Gymnastics is a very popular among girls. So here you can see here the gymnastic is used here in this sentence is one of the departments. It is not completely pointed out for any particular incident. It is a common acceptable notion. Gymnastic is very popular among the girls and it is referred as one of the departments that is mostly liked by the girls. Whenever you are using any term or any word in the for one organized activity, at that time you have to use the verb in the singular form. But whenever you are pointing out that particular word for one particular individual at that time. You have to use that particular word in the form of the plural form, and you have to use the verb in the plural form as well. The gymnastics shown in the field today were outstanding. So in this example, the particular, the individual, the individual activity, the individual, we can say subject, and the department is pointed out. That's why we are using verb here, the plural verb here. Then we have the 18th rule, that is the name of a country is always regarded as singular. Whenever you are pointing out the name of the country, you have to use a singular verb there. The Bahamas has beautiful beaches. Philippines is a wonderful, wondrous place. Whenever you are giving reference of the any country at that time, you have to use a singular verb there. 19. Adjectives used as nouns are considered plural. There are many adjectives which are used as nouns. At that time, they are considered as a plural. The poor are to be helped. You can see poor are to be helped. Adjective used as nouns. These poor, we can say poverty. Okay, that is poverty. That is considered as the adjectives. But whenever you are using the adjectives in the form in the context or in the meaning of the noun, at that time we have to use the plural form of verb there. Then efficient are what this country needs. Again, the same is the case here. 20th rule, that is collective nouns may be singular or plural depending on whether the individual members are acting individually or collectively. These nouns are company, company, group, committee, crowd, jury, flock and team. These are the collective nouns. One name is used for the whole group, and these nouns and the verbs depends on the, whether the individual members are acting individually or collectively. If the collective meaning is there, then we have to use the that word in the singular, and the verb, we have to use the verb in the singular form. And if we are pointing out any one individual from that particular company or from that collective noun, then we have to use a plural type of the verb there. For example, the committee is against the plan. So committee is the one part that is used for a complete group. So we can use here the singular verb, acting collectively singular. But if we are committee, we have another example, that is the committee or of different opinion. In the committee, here it represents the plural form. In the committee, there are the many people, and all of those people have the different opinion. That's why we have to use this word committee in the plural context here. In the use of the mathematical expressions, the following are accepted. 7 plus 3 is 10. 7 and 3 are 10. You have to see that how these words are used in the mathematics subjects. 5 times 2 are 10. 5 minus 2 is 3. Then we have 22 rules, that is titles of the book, plays, articles, movies, etc. are regarded as singular even though words in the title may be plural. The title may be plural, but you have to use the titles of the books, plays and articles and movies in the singular form. For example, In Dream Begins Responsibility. This is the title of the book, is a story by D. Squares. So you have to use the singular verb here, even if the title of the books are in the plural form. Great Expectation, that is also another book. That is a famous book. That is is a must-read novel. So you have to use the title of the books and the movies in there, and you have to use a singular verb along with those titles. Names of the organizations take a singular verb when the whole organization is referred to. Whenever the whole organization is referred, at that time the name of that organization is used in the singular form, and singular verb is used there. And the plural verb when the members are referred, when you are particularly referring to the member of that organization, then you have to use a plural verb. And if you are using the name of the one organization as a whole, at that time you have to use a singular verb there. For example, Lopez and Sons is a successful organization. So these are the organization names of the organization, Lopez and Sons. At that time, you have to use a singular verb there because you are just using and taking the name of the organizations, not the people of the organizations individually. So Lopez and Sons is a successful organization. Lopez and Sons are holding a two-day annual meeting. These are the members, are the individuals of that organization. That's why we have to use the plural verb here. 24 rule, that is, if a sentence begins with the expletive IT, the verb is always singular, even if the subject that follows the verb is plural. What is written here? If a sentence begins with expletive IT, if the particular institute or the department is used there, the verb is always singular. And if the subject that follows a verb is plural, the verb is always singular, even if the subject that follows a verb is plural. See, it is the schools. It is the schools. Schools is a noun that is used in the plural form. It must assume the responsibility. And it is us who must take care of the environment. Then we have last one slide that includes the references here, where from this material is taken. And we have discussed the different rules, 23 to 24 rules, that how to use the subject verb agreement and what are the different rules and in which condition we can change the formation and the structure of the sentences. And we have now how can we move and how can we write down these things in a proper way, in a clear manner. Hopefully you have got the ideas and you have understood these rules and regulation, where to use and how to use and how to make the different sentences of by using the particular names of the organization and particular words there as well. So these are the rules that we have discussed, and we have discussed the topic of the subject verb agreement, with that how the subject agrees with the verb and how the verb agrees with the subject and how they are interrelated with each other.